When you heard that knocking on the door, were you scared?
My heart skipped a beat, and then I just followed her. I thought it was like an armed robber or something. Because we heard it on our back door too.
Well, we thought, because our bed is like against the back wall, mm-hmm. So I thought, like, when I first heard it, it was someone at one of my neighbor's place pounding on their back door. So I was like, what in the world? And then, like, it just kept getting closer. So by the time he had gotten to us, I was a well alert, and I was like, who's there and what do you want?
It was after midnight. And then all of a sudden we hear pounding like this on each one of the doors. We heard it 3 times or more. And then we got up in a rush and went to a door, went to the front door. And then the man said, help me, help me. I got stabbed. And then he started showing us the wound. And then she started calling 911, and I let him in. She told him to sit on the computer chair. It's right over there. And then I went to get a kitchen towel. And then I started wiping the wound. And then I went in the room to get my towel and then put it on his back. And then I showed a while later, like 30 minutes later, the police came and an ambulance. Firearms started coming to the house.
They had a domestic dispute at their house. So he came here with the weapon in his hand. And Dre bravely took it from him and placed it on the computer table, I think it was. And we followed 911's instructions.
So tell me, what was going through your mind at that point in time when you saw that you need this guy needed help?
I was like, what should I do? What should I do?
Yeah, he did. He kind of did something with his head, because I was on the phone with 911 at the window speaking to the gentleman, and it's the window right beside my front door. And Dre just kind of did something with his head like this, which I know is him thinking. And then he just opened the door, and I was like, well, there we go. And he just started helping him. He was asking him a lot of questions, I guess, making sure that he stayed conscious.
That is
and stuff,
very brave.
You know?
Did you ever think that you'd have to do something like that?
At this point, no. I imagine this happening with other people, but not me.
And for you as a mom, seeing him spring into action like that?
I was shocked, but to see him act like that, and you know, I knew that the wheels in his head was turning from the time I saw that little ping pong with his head, but I didn't expect him to open the door. I was kind of waiting on 911 to let me know, you know, what I should do, because I didn't know if this gentleman was being followed. I didn't know at first. Initially I was like, is this fake, you know, like, is this this could be somebody coming in to hurt us, right? But I'm there running those scenarios through my head and on the phone with 911, but they're getting all these details from me, like my name, all of this stuff. I didn't think, okay, let the guy in and let's tend to him, but Dre did. I would strongly encourage parents and other kids, you know, that are of age to definitely do first aid training. Dre has no first aid training. He has never been in a scenario. He has never been in anything like a car crash or anything like that. And I mean, what we saw was his natural instinct. That was nature. And I think it would be helpful, because if that situation had turned for the worse, Dre's actions was definitely very crucial and critical in that moment. And as I said before, where I took time to, you know, think about danger and all of that stuff, you know, he was just, you know, on it. And I think it's crucial that we train them from at this age. It's not something that I'm going to go to him and I'm going to say, oh, you know, and up to now I have not said to him, you know, Dre, I don't think you should have opened that door. I'm grateful that he did. As I said, it could have been a lot worse, but God was with us and I'm appreciative of that.
Do you, if you had a message to anyone out there, Dre, maybe kids around your age too, what would you say to them?
I would say thanks for supporting me.